Well, I got a call today about the job. Good news, nothing bad. I start Monday. So basically, I'll be there at 8 a.m. and I will actually be getting paid to do something. That's going to be awesome. Basically, I'm starting on server work. So my IDs and everything's not completely created yet. So it'll be a few days before I can log into the main university system, but I'll have a temporary ID that I can use at the site of the location I'll be at. So I expect probably the first few weeks just really catching up what they have, really kind of going through everything, making sure I understand what's what, making sure I know what where the big red button that you do not push is. In like all the movies, it's like there's like that one big red button, do not push. Or like in a, oh, what was the Tom Hanks movie, Joe versus the Volcano? Like there's the big valve thing that he that it says do not turn or do not open or something like that. And the last when he finds out that when he thinks he's dying, and he walks up to it, just turns it. He goes, "What? That's it? I've been staring at the same for years. I haven't what know what it does. That's it." So basically, I'm trying to figure out what are those things you just don't touch. But so I think it's going to be awesome to actually get back out in the working world right now. It's just been a little while. So happy about that. Oh man, what else? Trying to think exactly what else we. I went to the gym. I didn't have much time, so what I basically got on the stair stepper, stayed on it for about 45 minutes, and God, that about killed me. Because I tried, okay, what I tried, I know, like, I looked online, it's like my heart rate needs to be, like, for my age, is like between, I can't remember, but I think the upper is like 160. So what I try to do is I try to keep my heart rate at like 158. It fluctuates up and down. And generally goes between 155 and like 162, something like that. And so what I do is I'm on the machine. That there's these two bars that stick out, and I hold those so that it monitors my heart rate. And I find a level that's going to keep me around that, and that's around level 6 on this machine. And holy cow. Staying at what I did is I downloaded the newest episode of The Grand Tour. If you don't know what that is, that's the new show that Jeremy Clarkson, James May, and Richard Hammond do. The guys that used to be on Top Gear, they got a new show called Grand Tour, and it's really good. It's really funny. If you've never seen it, check it out. You got to be an Amazon Prime member. But I downloaded that and I was watching it while I was on the stair stepper. And that helps a lot to actually have something to entertaining to do, and not you're just not staring out the window. But as I was exercising, there was a point because I really didn't eat lunch, and I was there exercising. And there's a point, probably about I'd say about 30 minutes into it, that I just felt horrible because I mean, really, because like it's like your body's like, okay, there's nothing in your stomach. Or your stomach's getting like you're getting low on food. You're hungry. You need to eat. Stop this, whatever you're doing. And it just like all of a sudden I was just like, oh. But I was like, all right, I'm just going to finish this, and then I'm going to go home because I was going to lift and everything. But feeling like that, there's no way I could have. I'd have ended up throwing up or something. So after that. Actually, I got a thing for my son's bed so that he can't like roll out of it. What else? Went to the grocery store, got a few things. So, very eventful day. I really can't wait to. But what I really can't wait for is to see Monday. I get an office. I don't know if I'll get. I'm not gonna be like, oh, I got an office with a name tag and everything. No, most likely I'll probably have a desk in the corner. That's actually that's not far from where I've been in some places. I went from a cubicle, when I worked at a call center, to sharing an office, to having my own office, back to a cubicle. Yeah. I have to say, I don't like working in cubicles. But these ones, like the ones I've originally, when I was at EDS, in a call center, they come up to about to my chin. So, like, you could look over them. The ones that I had in my last job, they were, I mean, if you stood up, they came up to, like, your waist. So you could see all the way across the floor and everything. We only had, like, 30 employees at this place, though. But, yeah. Oh, I know I talked about used video games the other day. And today, I went back to half-price books. And, like I said, Castlevania 4, I really never see out. Contra, I never see out. And I went back there today, and they have two copies of Castlevania 4 and two copies of Contra. And it looks like somebody brought in, like, a bunch of Super Nintendo games. And I'm looking at all these, and I'm like, these all look really nice. I mean, like, don't get me wrong. It's possible that somebody traded all these in. And they had some not extremely rare games, but most of these games are in the $30 to $40 range. And I'm like, I'd like to be able to open some of these games up and see exactly how many of them are legit. Because, like, there's a few games there I could look at and be like, all right, looking through the case, I can tell it's a real game. But some of them, I mean, I'm like, this game looks really clean. Either this person's taken very good care of his games, or this game's new. And, like, this is basically a repo or something, a reproduction. And I haven't seen a lot, but I've seen a few. And you're kind of like, wait a minute, what? This game doesn't look right. And a lot of times it's the feel of it, you can tell, or the sticker on it doesn't look right, or something like that. And it's just, I understand people are trying to make a buck, but it's just, I don't know. People seem like they were just, right now, they want to steal and con their way to money. And I'm like, do you understand that when you get caught, and it's generally when, not if, counterfeit goods is not a crime you want to be caught for. I know, like, they, at Half Price Books at one time, they were thinking about selling some, reproductions, or, I can't remember, there's, like, some kind of, ROM hack, or something, I can't remember, it's a weird, they had, like, three of them, and one of the guys that works there, he asked me about it, and I was like, wouldn't do it. They're like, why not? He goes, I don't understand. It's like, okay, how about this? I got some great reproduction DVDs to bring in here to sell to you guys. And I said that, he was like, oh. And he understood, you can just burn a DVD, but a video game is a little bit more difficult, but it can be done, and still just as illegal. I know some games, the company doesn't exist anymore, and the license is kind of like in limbo. You don't really know who owns it. But most video games, the company still exists. Anything that's really expensive, most of them, either Capcom, Nintendo, Konami, things like that, they still own those licenses, and they keep them. They keep them under, I mean, they don't want anybody making new copies of games. But yeah. I'm sitting here playing a piece of plastic. I'm not sure why. You're probably hearing that in your ears, thinking it's your headphones static. Even though, I don't know. For some reason, I'm just playing with it. I'm tossing it on my couch. I'll clean that up later. But I don't know. I just keep thinking about the job. The only thing I'm worried about is I'm going in there and, like, I don't know all the rules. Like, okay, I have no idea what the dress code is, so I'm going to dress up. I'm going to wear a button-up shirt, and I'm going to go in and see how everybody else is dressed. And that's generally what I do. First few days, I kind of scope out how everybody else is dressed, and then that's what I do. Also, I always carry a pocket knife. Okay, since I'm going to be on a university campus, is that something you can do? I mean, I won't be actually, I won't be on the main campus, but this is a camp being the university, employee of the university. Like, can I carry that? What else is there? Like, can you listen to music? Can you, what can you, can't you do? Generally, I'd never put anything. Okay, this is this is some advice for anybody that's working at any type of computer job. Never go to anything non-work related on your work computer. And I've told this to many people, and it's so many times it's come to bite them in the butt. Because when I was a network administrator, I told for people the first day, I was like, never go to any website that's not work related. And they're like, oh, why? And it's like, and I said, no matter what, this information people, and I actually somebody said, what, like somebody told me after like this, like they said, I've been going to Facebook for weeks and nobody's ever said anything. I said, it's not that nobody watches, they don't care, but when there's a problem, and they're like, hey, we like, and it's not a problem with you, it could be like, we need to downsize. All right, who should we get rid of first? And the first thing they do is said. That they the guy would come they would come to me and say, we need a report on what websites and how long these people spend, how long our employees spend on them. And because we had a proxy server, all this stuff was kept track of. And I was like, okay, I pulled the report. I didn't look at it because I don't care. I don't want to know this information, because if somebody asks me, I don't want to. I can say, I, if you have the authority to have me pull the report, I'll send you the report. I don't look at it. If you want me to help you interpret it, I can do that. But that's all I'll do. Most of the time, most employ. I mean, it's so simple. It's like this website, they spent this much time on this day, type things. And sometimes you can break it down. It's like, okay, over the past month, they've spent this much time on this. And I told him, I was like, and if they. We're like, I want to know how much time this person spends on Facebook in the past week. And if it's like oh, they spent 5 hours. Oh, I, the, and you only went to Facebook on lunch. But that report said you spent 5 hours on Facebook. That's over half your work day. They don't care that, oh, you did it on lunch. They just know that you spent 5 hours in the past week on Facebook. And that may be the reason why you get cut over somebody else. And he was like, oh, wow. And that's why I try to, like, if you're on your phone and you're not, repeat, not on the company's Wi-Fi, you're using your own cellular data, I don't care. Because if you're not doing your job, your boss is going to find out and you're going to get fired for it. But when you're all, like, the thing is, I always told somebody, like, when you're on my network, and they're like, well, and like somebody's like, well, it's the company's network. I was like, well, I'm maintaining it. It's my network. When you when and if they if you screw it up and you make my job harder, it's not it's not good, because I'm not going to be looking to do anything against you, because that's not what I do. But when you make my job harder, I can lock your machine down to where you can't even right click in your mouse. I never did that to anybody. It was mainly, I said it's a joke, and they understood that it's a joke, but a lot sometimes some people would go to very bad sites, and like we actually I had actually had somebody go to a torrent site and was trying. We had a pretty good connection at my last job, and they were trying to download movies, and it's like, okay. I can see how much our bandwidth. That's something we did monitor on our bandwidth, because we wanted to make sure, because we dealt with a lot of VPNs, want to make sure that there was no bandwidth issues with the VPN and stuff like that. So when our usage started going up to our limit, and we had, gosh, how fast of a, I don't even remember. It was really it was. I mean, it was close to a T. I mean, it wasn't like a T. It was through a cable company. But it was dedicated and it wasn't a shared. But no, wait, no, that was, I don't even remember anymore. It's been so long. But it was close. It was over a T1 speed, but you never really got that. But something, somebody was downloading things at like 100 megabit a second. It was like crazy speeds. And I was like, what's going on here? I thought somebody might have downloaded some ISOs or something like that, like for Linux, because some people did deal with virtual machines. And I'm like, okay, something. I look at this, like, okay, what's going on here? I see some, like, a lot of traffic in and out. So I thought, okay, I'm not going to assume the worst. I'm going to think somebody's downloading an ISO. Maybe they need a virtual machine installed, and they're going to use Linux. So I'm like, okay, let's see who it is. I see the IP address. We know whose computer's associated with every IP address. I see who's logged into it. Okay, I know the person logged into it. And then I'm like, all right, let's see what's going on here. And I see BitTorrent traffic. And I'm like, oh, okay, this is great. So basically, I blocked their computer. Drop it from the network so that it has no network connectivity. And I just wait for them to come to my desk to tell me, hey, I can't access anything. This generally takes 2 or 3 minutes. And not because that, oh, they noticed their download or anything, but because they're generally trying to work and they can't work. They come in, hey, I can't get to the network. I'm like, okay, let me check. I'm like, oh, it's probably, I would say we have something, you may have some spyware, because we saw there's a lot of traffic coming from your computer. We want to make sure, the system wanted to make sure you weren't sending out virus packets. So it was your computer is quarantined. I'll need to look at it and see, make sure nothing's. And they were like, oh, maybe I'll just. And most of the time, most of them be like, oh, wait, I'm probably disconnected. Okay, let me go check. And they wouldn't come back. And then I'd wait like 10 minutes and then I'd put them back on the network and see if they were trying to download anything. And most of the time, most people understood that. You'd be caught pretty quickly. But every so often there'd be somebody that would try it again and try it again and try it again. It's like they were trying, they really wanted to get something. And it just got to the point where I would actually limit the speed to somebody's computer. I understand we don't want BitTorrent on our network and everything. And I would actually have to go tell people, hey, you're doing something on your computer you're not supposed to. Okay. And all this stuff was because we generated reports about, because a lot of our clients, they wanted certain type of reports to make sure our network was secure. And I said, and I would be like, hey, this stuff's logged. This stuff is, and one guy just did not understand that. This stuff is being logged, and this stuff, if I let him do it, it comes on me. So basically, he was making my job harder. And actually, basically, the only thing at one point, the only thing I could do is just basically inform our boss, like, hey, I think somebody's doing something on their computer they shouldn't be. And at that point, I don't tell him. I know what it is. I don't tell my boss what it is. He goes, okay, let me pull the report, see what he's been doing on his computer. I basically pull the report, email it to him. He looks at it, and next day the guy was gone. I can't really say I got him. Technically, I didn't get him fired. He got himself fired because he was doing things that was going to cause a lot of problems for a lot of people. And it's just the guy couldn't allow it to into the network. So, and then I was pulled into the office after he was let go. And the guy was, he was on torrent sites. Looked like he was downloading stuff. And it was, and I was like, mm-hmm. You probably knew. I'm not saying you did, but he said, thank you for informing me. And the thing was, is that we had two clients that routinely came to our offices and actually ran security audits of our systems like every 3 months. And that would have been something that would have pegged on their radar going, hey, what is this here? You need to take care of this. There's somebody doing stuff in your network you shouldn't be doing. And and the thing is, and when they came in the next time, they did see it. They were like, wait, you have this big spike here in this traffic. You have this in your logs. What was going on? And I basically at that point, I was like, that was an HR. That was an issue with an employee that if you want more detail, you'd have to talk with my boss. And he was like, oh, okay. And at that point, he understood, hey, somebody was doing something. We found it out. We got rid of him. And so, yeah, that was the one. I think that was like the only thing that would really get you fired is if you were downloading stuff through BitTorrent that you shouldn't have been. Because I downloaded ISOs through BitTorrent with Linux ones. I downloaded some stuff for Microsoft, and it made things easier to download things that way and a lot quicker. But you always had to MD5 check everything because people would every so often try to screw with your downloads. If you are using BitTorrent, I highly recommend using the MD5 check some. If you don't know what that is, look it up. Basically, every file, what you do is when you download it, there's an MD5 hash, like generally on the page with it. When you download it, there's either a program or a command. If you're on Linux, there's a command you can run that will give it, but that will basically take the file, hash it, and you should get the same number back. If you don't, it means the file's not the same one that was on that you think you're downloading. It's been modified in some way or corrupted, which is most of the time. But I have seen things have a different the MD5 hash, and it always makes me wary. And when that happens, I generally re-download it. So yeah. Wow, that kind of evolved into a different conversation I thought it would go to. But yeah. Job Monday. Very happy. Hope you guys have a good weekend. It's going to be frantic here. Especially for Adrian, adjusting to me being gone a lot. But he loves his grandparents, so they're going to be watching him as while I'm at work. So everything will be good. Have a good weekend. See you guys tomorrow.